Hi, good evening viewers. We're here to talk to Mr. Mohit Chaubey, who has recently written his first book, which is on 1000 Kilometers to Leadership. And welcome Mr. Mohit.
Thanks a lot. Good to be here with you.
Same here. So if you could talk a little about your journey, how you started, and your corporate experience, and how did you end up writing this book?
Sure. I think the journey has been quite long. Many of you might be aware that I have been in the business, rather in the corporate world, for the past 22 years.
Right.
And I've spent close to 17 years in leadership assignments across the country. Mm-hmm. However, a few years back, maybe a decade back or so, I got into running, and it was by chance, and it's covered incidentally in the book as to the reasons why I started doing so.
Right.
Maybe I leave that to the readers to find out once they do so. But for me, putting pen to paper regarding this book started once I finished participated in one of the most iconic ultra marathons in the world.
Oh, great.
This is in South Africa, and this is a 90 kilometer run between Pietermaritzburg and Durban over mountainous terrain. So I think that was the trigger point for me to move beyond endurance sports and sharing my thoughts, sharing my learnings, and sharing the journey which I have been through for the past few years.
That's great. And then how did you get about writing the book and about the trilogy that you just mentioned? How did that idea come along?
The story was always there. I think the story kind of germinated in my mind once I finished the Comrades Marathon and I just crossed that Rubicon, and I was like, okay, there is too much which needs to be captured, too much which needs to be shared. This journey has been so enriching for me. I think the germination happened there. However, COVID was responsible for me being able to put pen to paper because it allowed me more time.
A breathing space for writers like us. Wouldn't have much time, and they had a lot of...
Basically, what happened for me was that my commuting time to office...
It's tough to juggle and everything.
So yeah. I was traveling every day 2.5 hours coming and going to work. So
yeah.
Effectively, the 2.5 hours now went into putting my thoughts together for putting the book together. So like I said, this is the first of the trilogy. Mm-hmm. And it's doing remarkably well in terms of the response which I'm getting from readers.
Right. Yeah, the response has been great, I heard.
Yeah, so it's been at the number one for new releases across three segments in Amazon. And within athletics, it's in the top four, I think, best sellers.
Oh,
so,
great.
It's very heartening. It's good to know that not only is it doing well, but it's doing well across multiple categories.
Right.
And that's something I would want to dwell upon, because basically it means that it is for a broad spectrum of readers.
Right.
It is not meant for runners or endurance athletes only. However, it may be possible that the endurance athletes and runners might derive more joy from reading it.
Mm-hmm.
However, the journey is all about life.
Mm-hmm.
It is not merely about running.
Right. Okay, great. Can you quote something from the book for the readers?
Yeah, so this is something which is very impactful, and something which I truly believe in. And it says, do not end up becoming a footnote in your own autobiography. I think this is something which was a Eureka moment for me in terms of defining what I would want to do with my life and what I believe each one of us needs to do with their life. There might be different derivations which each one of us might want to take out from this, but for me it's simply about take charge of your life and do what you feel you're good at and what makes you feel good, and hence drive the agenda which you want to drive, rather than just be a tag along for many other people or situations.
Right. So our audience would like to know, what would be your message to first time authors who want to get their book published? Do you think a traditional publishing or self-publishing option is good, and how do they go about it?
I would like to believe that if you're an author, you need to back yourself. You need to have confidence in what you're going to say. You need to have confidence that the story which you're going to put out there will have an audience, and not merely an audience, somebody who will really enjoy it. And in such a scenario, I would suggest that don't take half measures. Go with the best, go with people who are willing to work with you, who have as much hunger in publishing that book to see it be successful. And for me, I'm thankful that Invincible Publishers was one such publisher who is willing to put as much effort into ensuring that it reaches the broader audience as much as I have wanted to.
Yes, because nowadays marketing the book is much more important. After the distribution obviously has to be pretty
good. In any scenario, the precursor is obviously the product needs to be good.
Right. Yeah.
Having a good product is a prerequisite. However, that in itself is not sufficient. And sufficiency is only when you ensure that sufficient people are aware of it, and distribution ensures the delivery of the product. So I think a good product along with a good visibility and distribution,
yes,
that those are hallmarks for a successful book as far as I believe.
Definitely. Great chatting with you, and it was a very good experience. Good luck for your next book.
Thank you.
One of the trilogies.
Yeah, so I'm working on two of them. One is on the trilogy and the other is a different genre. But yeah, I'm looking forward to publishing the three of them and hoping to see the response getting even more impactful. Thanks, Pat.
Great. Thanks a lot for your time. Thank you, viewers.